I think it's time to start. Are you ready to go, Yasha?
Yes, I get ready.
Okay, so we're welcome to the plenary talk in this session on symplectic topology and dynamics. We're very happy to have Yasha Eliashberg, who will speak about the program of arborealization. And if you have any questions, please type into the chat that you have a question.
Daniel Álvarez-Gavela will be answering kind of like intermediately together with me. Okay, so let me start. So first of all, this is our joint work with Daniel Álvarez-Gavela and David Nadler. So it's the first part of this project. We also collaborated with Laura Starkston, but then she decided that she kind of like do other stuff. So also I want to mention that John Pardon contributed some important ideas to our project, and probably not that essential for the current stage, but maybe will be essential for the next stage of what we are going to do. So one of central object of differential topology is smooth manifold, of course, and we study it up to diffeomorphism, and manifold are kind of nice that they all locally standard, locally Euclidean space. So one of the central object of symplectic topology in this, from the point of view which we want to propagate, is slightly more general, and it may have several local models in a given dimension. It is called an arboreal space. So this is a kind of like example of arboreal space. You just take a two manifold with boundary and take a immersion of one of this manifold into interior of the other and just glue two parts together. And you want this immersion to have a transverse self-intersection. So this is a kind of typical arboreal space. So just, I want to stress the point that arboreal space is a something pure, the object of differential topology, if you wish. It has kind of nothing else. It has something to do with symplectic topology. It came from symplectic topology, but it can viewed, you kind of like never mention the word symplectic structure and still do this, study the topology of this arboreal spaces, and the corollaries will be some results in symplectic topology. So the problem is that equivalence relation for this object is more involved than just diffeomorphism. For instance, one can, as in this example, you have this one piece attached to the where this immersion, and you're allowed to move this within some kind of regular homotopy. Of course, this regular homotopy may have sometimes tangents, it cannot stay self-transverse, but what you don't allow to have what Arnold called dangerous tangency, is that means a point where this co-orientation is a tangency point coincide. So one also would like to allow some other operation on this arboreal spaces. For instance, you can remove, like in this picture, remove some part of the manifold and re-glue it back, like in this picture, perpendicular along some, say, push off of the boundary of the removed piece. So, for instance, R2 non-diffeomorphic homotopy sphere, which of course we know can be made by gluing two discs, are they equivalent via this equivalence relation? So it's corollary of a theorem of Mohammed Abu Zaid, and with some improvement by Tobias Ekholm, Ivan Smith, that if they are equivalent, then this homotopy sphere have to bound parallelizable manifold. And it's unknown where they have to be diffeomorphic or not. So question, is there a proof without leaving the realm of smooth topology, not going to this kind of theory or modeling space of holomorphic curve in order to prove this fact, which seems to have nothing to do with symplectic topology. So even this is kind of like more special question is which is kind of like completely open and would be nice to have the answer. So take it like inclusion of n minus one sphere to Rn and reparametrize it by some different orientation preserving diffeomorphism. The question is our original inclusion and this reparametrized map are regular homotopic without dangerous self-tangency. It immediately follows from Smale theory that they are regular homotopic. But the question, are they regular homotopic without dangerous self-tangencies? So again, we don't have this is kind of unfortunately, I have a cutting of top of the screen. Okay, anyway, now let me kind of like, so I said, kind of our program is to get rid of symplectic topology and replace it with this some strange version of smooth topology, but still I need to first talk about symplectic topological notion. And luckily, Ko already introduced a lot of these notions which I need. But I'll just briefly repeat it. So first of all, we will be always dealing with the exact symplectic manifold, and this Liouville form is a primitive of symplectic form, and the kind of important object is a dual vector field for this form, and this dual vector field is kind of known to be kind of equivalent its definition that conformally symplectic, so the flow of this vector field is multiply form and actually even lambda by e to the t. So we want to impose some condition at infinity for this manifold. As Ko said, this dynamic of Liouville field can be kind of terrible, and we want to a little bit improve this condition on this dynamic. So this is not absolutely kind of maximum what we can ask, but we just for purposes of this talk, it's sufficient. We will consider this manifold what is called with cylindrical n. That means that we require that there exists some hypersurface. There is some subdomain bounded, compact subdomain bounded by hypersurface, which is transverse to Liouville field. And complement of this domain is in fact foliated by trajectory of Liouville field emanating from the boundary. So you have the boundary and kind of like inside dynamics can be terrible, but here outside they kind of very simple. So the such manifold usually called Liouville manifold, and the domain W itself called Liouville domain, and we will be calling it defining Liouville domain for Liouville manifold X. So unlike Liouville domain, Liouville manifold has no boundary, but it still has this ideal contact boundary, just as a quotient of this end with respect to Liouville flow. And this ideal boundary inherit canonical contact structure, not contact form, but contact structure. So I already said that Liouville flow rescale Liouville form, and hence you can look at the skeleton of this negative flow, and the skeleton under our assumption is compact, and it automatically has volume zero because this Liouville field in negative direction contracts the form and therefore the volume. But kind of generally it's not more than just volume zero. For instance, it could be hypersurface. So there is this kind of nice condition for Liouville dynamics, which already was mentioned by Ko, called manifold, Liouville manifold was Weinstein type or simply Weinstein, if this Liouville vector field admits Lyapunov Morse function, which means that Z is another way to say it, Z is a gradient like for this F. So this Morse condition is a little bit too restrictive, so it could be relaxed. For instance, we can assume that it's generalized Morse, so that means it has a cubic critical point, or it's Morse bot, but it's unknown, unfortunately, whether it can be completely removed. Maybe it can be completely removed. That means that if you have any such function, maybe you have, say, Morse function for after some small perturbation, but we don't know this. So, of course, the point of view of manifold has an advantage that if you have a deformation of this Liouville structure or Weinstein structure on this completed manifold, then in fact you can follow it by symplectic isotopy. So this homotopic Liouvillean Weinstein manifold are symplectomorphic. Of course, this is not true for domain, but if we are kind of like content with just classifying them up to Weinstein homotopy, which, by the way, this notion is kind of not known to be stronger equivalence relation. It's maybe potentially the same. We don't know this. And maybe from co-work, it follows some kind of that it's in fact the same. But anyway, but at this moment it's unknown. And so then from homotopic point of view, this kind of point of view of domain and manifold is equivalent. And in fact, what we are going to think in some sense opposite to this completed manifold, because we want to think about this object as a just germ along the skeleton. So just kind of like any two defining surface as small as they could be are equivalent. So the whole structure just defined as some kind of structure on the neighborhood of a skeleton. And we will be kind of mainly propagating this point of view. So we're really kind of not interested here on the size type question. Okay, so even I cannot read what is written here, but I can guess. So so kind of like, of course, prototypical example of Liouville Weinstein manifold is just cotangent bundle, which is endowed with a standard Liouville form PDQ and standard radial Liouville vector field. So this is a precisely Morse bot case of this Weinstein manifold, because like corresponding Lyapunov function at just distance square to the zero section. So the skeleton in this case is of course exactly our manifold M. So, but now we would like to, so this is kind of strange because this is only cotangent bundle of closed manifolds. If I take a cotangent bundle of manifold with boundary, with canonical Liouville form PDQ, then in the previous definition, it's not a Weinstein manifold. Because like behavior near the boundary of the manifold is a kind of, is not the one. It's our Liouville field tangent there to the boundary, near the boundary, rather to be transverse. So nevertheless, we kind of want to introduce this notion. So we say, what is a Weinstein manifold with boundary? So this is a non-compact manifold with boundary. Again, let me kind of stress the point that this infinity I don't view as a boundary. And so the boundary is this, for me, it's this kind of like what would be horizontal boundary for the cotangent bundle of manifold with boundary. And what I want is Liouville vector field complete and tangent to the boundary of this manifold. And there is some compact, like in the closed case, there exists some compact domain, but maybe kind of I draw so you have this thing with boundary, and there is this compact domain, and this compact domain have two part of boundary. So one part of boundary is inside boundary of my Weinstein manifold, and other part is inside, and our Liouville vector field is transverse to the is tangent to the boundary, but transverse to this vertical boundary. I will be sometimes referring this to vertical boundary. So this is a vertical boundary, although it looks horizontal, and this is a horizontal boundary, although it looks vertical. Okay, so so we have one more condition. I want to kind of insist that there exists some 2n minus 2 dimensional Weinstein manifold in sitting in the boundary, and such that the neighborhood of the boundary is in fact split as a product of this Weinstein hypersurface and cotangent bundle of semi-open interval, where this form of the subsemi interval is a standard UDT form. So this is exactly what happened if you take a manifold with boundary and take a coordinate T, which is a, like color coordinates near the boundary. So the boundary in this case, like T equal to zero. So I will be calling this Y nucleus of the boundary. So for instance, cotangent bundle of the boundary is a nucleus of the boundary of cotangent bundle of manifold with boundary. Boundary itself is just restriction of big cotangent bundle to the boundary. And a nucleus is a something of dimension 2n minus 2. So one can similarly, in fact, one would like to push it further and define notion of Weinstein manifold with boundary with corners, or just Weinstein manifold with corners. So we will just saying WC manifold for short. So this is a kind of, it would be generalized, like you can take a manifold, smooth manifold with corners, and where you, on the boundary, you have a manifold neighborhood of diffeomorphic to a product of some smaller dimension manifold by quadrant of corresponding dimensions. And here you can kind of obviously can generate and generalize it in very similar sense here. So in this case, our boundary, instead of boundary, we have a kind of many faces of the boundary, and each face of the boundary would have its own nucleus. Note that when we have a cotangent bundle of manifold with boundary, then of course, skeleton of this manifold is manifold itself, and therefore it goes to the boundary. So therefore, it in particular, it contains as a skeleton of the nucleus. And this is kind of common phenomena. If you have a manifold, Weinstein manifold with boundary, then its skeleton goes up to the boundary, and it's kind of intersects the boundary along skeleton of the corresponding nuclei of the faces. So there is some straightforward procedure of removing boundary and making it into Weinstein manifold. So we started with say cotangent bundle of manifold with boundary, and then near the boundary, there is this, like, as I said, there is this UDT form enter there, but you just replace it by TDU form, which kind of like, which makes this our Liouville vector fields transverse to the boundary. And then there is a very kind of standard procedure how you cut it off and still keep transversality to the boundary. And therefore you can make it the whole thing into Weinstein manifold. And what happened by this procedure that in fact our new skeleton kind of become look like this. It's just exactly the same, but slightly the boundary pushed inside. So the with this kind of local modification near the boundary, this is kind of what happened with the skeleton, with this deformation. So, but then this operation, like there are still remnants of this nucleus. So here we had this nucleus, and now there are kind of like after we remove it, there are still remnants of this local nucleus in the boundary. And this remnant, we call it Weinstein hypersurface or WC hypersurface, because itself can have these corners. So this is a kind of absolutely parallel idea to all this kind of stops of Sylvan and kind of like many other kind of like related things. So so there is a, as I said, this Weinstein hypersurfaces is kind of, there's a several way of thinking that. So one, you can say, okay, so you just take codimension two locally closed submanifold in the complement of the skeleton of the manifold, such that restriction of the Liouville form of ambient manifold give me Liouville form on the submanifold. And such that when I project along the Liouville flow to the ideal boundary, this is an embedding. So that's kind of one definition. Alternatively, you can view it as just that it lies in the in the boundary of defining domain, and again with the conditions that Liouville form restrict to it. And yet another way you can just think of it, that it's a, if you think about a manifold as infinite manifold, you can think that this hypersurface sits at infinity and just this Liouville form mu is proportional to the contact form defining the standard contact structure at infinity. The inverse, there is also inverse conversion operation. You can take a Weinstein hypersurface, WC hypersurface, and make it into boundary nucleus, a kind of exactly opposite. And kind of interesting happened with skeleton when you do this, namely, you started with your manifold and you have this, like it has a, its own skeleton. And now you take this Weinstein hypersurface, and this Weinstein hypersurface has its own skeleton. And after we converted it, so this kind of now becoming, so our Liouville form become kind of tangent to this. And actually what happened that Liouville cone over the skeleton of this manifold added to skeletons of the whole manifold. So the class of arboreal singularities, now the time to make some definition, is a minimal class which is closed under the following operation. So suppose we already defined Lagrangian with arboreal singularity in dimension n. We can then define n-dimensional arboreal Legendrian also as a just lift of arboreal Lagrangian cotangent bound of Rn to the one jet space. And then we can do the following thing. Take cotangent bound of Rn plus one, look at cotangent bound Rn plus one is a arboreal Legendrian of dimension n, and assuming that its projection is on each strata is immersion, and moreover that all strata in the projection intersect self-transversely, then we can take this just the union of this cone over this Legendrian and the union zero section, and you get a picture in the dimension n in cotangent bound of Rn plus one. So this is a kind of like, this operation define all arboreal Legendrian. So this arboreal Legendrian kind of naturally locally enumerated by rooted decorated trees. So suppose we have a tree with a root rho and decoration epsilon. This decoration assigns sign to each edge. So you just take this tree, and you have this rooted tree. So there is some root, and to all edges not emanating from the root, we assign plus or minus one. So this is decoration. And in the case when the decoration consists of all pluses, we say that this arboreal singularity is positive. So each tree with n plus one vertices yields a model which first appears in cotangent bundle of Rn, and then can be stabilized by multiplying by Rk. Excuse me? Oh, and then multiplying by zero section Rk in
cotangent. Here she is, all right.
In cotangent bundle of Rk.
She's right.
Then we get a model. Yeah,
good. Come on in. Okay, you gotta be worried for a minute.
When n equals zero, of course the tree is just a point, and this is a point lies in cotangent bound of R0. So consequently, you can stabilize it to Rk in T star of Rk. So this is what corresponds to kind of trivial tree from one point. So when n equal two, the original model is a T-like complex obtained as a union of line and this Liouville cone of a previous arboreal model, which is a point, and you get this kind of T-like thing, and then you can further stabilize it and get kind of picture like this. So when equal three, the sign issue first appear. So now what we need to do, right? In the next stage, we have to take this arboreal Legendrian, which I already defined before, and we need to project it to R2. And the cotangent projection in this kind of, in the contact plane, induce some kind of Legendrian foliation. And this Legendrian foliation can be like this, or it can be like this, right? And so in depending on the choice, our front would of this picture would look either like this or like this. And this is a kind of symplectically not equivalent thing. And this is a precisely like where the sign appear each time, and kind of like just to say, so this first configuration where you have a direction of projection, this one, this correspond to plus, and this one correspond to minus for corresponding axis. So you see, in high dimension, this arboreal Lagrangian always would look like this. It always will be some Lagrangian plane. There's a half plane sum, and then kind of like there's a more thing coming to this, but tangent plane at the arboreal point always will be only two plane. Just will be always one plane, and will all be one plane, and because always automatically will be tangent at this point, it's always will be the picture. And so therefore, it's a kind of like one-dimensional situation. So this direction of projection, still only two possibility for this direction of projection. And that's why you get only sign distinction. So this is a so-called AN model, or just model for like corresponding to linear trees, is defined this way, but non-AN model is come from this kind of transverse intersection. So you have for instance, you project kind of one Legendrian, as there's a completely unrelated Legendrian over there, and I project them both, and in kind of like what I get a conormal kind of corresponding to this one, and this project to kind of something else, and you get a conormal on other one, and this is a like model which correspond to tree which kind of look like this. Okay, so this is a pretty natural thing. So by the way, I didn't say important thing kind of that like the whole concept of the arboreal singularities belongs to David Nadler, who introduced and studied them before we kind of engage into this project. So it's kind of amazing fact that there is a lot of flexibility of choosing this kind of projection. You can rotate this Legendrian this way, bend it, and kind of dual kind of different thing. And so you would think that this, there is some kind of moduli of this local moduli of this object. But amazingly, they are unique up to symplectomorphism. And so any two arboreal singularity described by the same rooted decorated tree are locally symplectomorphic. So we actually kind of first we didn't expect this to be true, but that turns out that this is a theorem which we proved. So this is a, of course, this kind of naturally leads to this notion of this pure differential topological notion of arboreal space as just a stratified space described by finite in every dimension list of local model unique up to diffeomorphism. And in fact, kind of what means, what diffeomorphism mean, you can kind of discuss it. So you can think, well, this is just say restriction of some ambient diffeomorphism for the space. But in fact, it's kind of sufficient to think about like piecewise smooth diffeomorphism, which is smooth on every smooth top dimensional part of this arboreal. So here is a kind of description of this canonical model. So let's kind of consider the family of this function, just kind of like we have a just start with zero, then x1, then take a x1 minus x2 square, then x1 minus x2 square square square, and etc. You iterate this kind of like procedure. And then you look at hypersurfaces, just graph of these functions. So then I don't want to take the whole graph. I take in each graph, I take certain quadrant. And which quadrant, so far when I, which graph I take is completely, so completely canonical independent. So this is kind of description for this AN singularity, but it's completely independent of all this decoration. But now you have a decoration and this decoration affect which quadrant I want to take. For instance, in the case of positive quadrant, I just take this quadrant cut by this inequality. So I'll show you in kind of next picture. And so, and then this is a kind of like, and then you get this object. So you get this, so this is a graph of these three functions. This is a gamma zero on the bottom. This is gamma one and this is gamma two. And you, out of gamma one, you just cut half of plane. Out of this, you cut this quarter of plane, which look like this. And if I have a different sign, I may get a, out of this, my hypersurface, I may, can take maybe different quadrants than this one. So each time I have a, like in fact, I have a, each time I have a possibility to choose one or of two quadrants. And so our main theorem give necessary and sufficient condition for a Weinstein manifold to admit what we call positive arboreal skeleton. So this condition is existence of stable polarization. So by polarization of symplectic manifold, we mean the choice of Lagrangian plane field. Of course, stable polarization, it's a choice of Lagrangian plane field in stabilized tangent bundle. And of course, from a homotopical point of view, this just means that if we have a reduction of group, which like symplectic or unitary to orthogonal group, or for stable unitary to stable orthogonal. So it's kind of easy to see that any stable polarization on two n dimensional manifold of homotopy type of n dimensional CW complex, and such are Weinstein manifold, can always be destabilized. So existence of stable polarization implies existence of unstable, but homotopy classification, unstable homotopy is not the same. It's a kind of a stronger relation than stable homotopy. So in dimension four, this condition just C1 equal to zero. So if you have a C1 equal zero, then automatically you have a polarization. And kind of in general, for instance, if you have a manifold whose stable tangent bundle split is the sum of line, complex line bundles, then it's admitted polarization. And important special cases affine complete intersections. So the main theorem is that if you have a polarized WC manifold with boundary, okay, like this is a redundant. If WC manifold automatic, it's a boundary with corner, then after possibly converting a additional WC hypersurface Y to boundary nucleus, the resulted WC structure is homotopic to the one with the positive arboreal skeleton. Conversely, existence of positive arboreal skeleton implies existence of polarization. So it's a necessary and sufficient condition for existence of polar skeleton. And let me kind of stress this point that, okay, so you have to, of course, add something. You cannot prove the theorem without adding extra boundary faces. For instance, you start with ball, the skeleton is a point, and you can convert it, of course, into cotangent bundle of the disk. But by doing this, you create we create a boundary of our Weinstein manifold. Of course, this boundary can be kind of removed. As I said, you can convert back and push it inside. So if you wish, you can kind of not talk about this kind of boundary case, because we talk about absolute case, but then you have to allow this boundary point of the arboreal, kind of the price that you pay, that you have a boundary point of arboreal. So this theorem is what we completed so far. So we just kind of, we have a paper with all proof already written, but kind of we just hope to finish it in kind of as soon as we can. Okay, cannot promise any date, but we have already passed few our internal deadlines. But the second part, what we kind of plan to do next, it describes the equivalence relation between arboreal skeleton and homotopic Weinstein structure. So kind of what are, if you want to reduce it to combinatorics, we need to kind of describe all possible moves which are allowed. Kind of we have some conjecture, but we didn't prove that. So, and the third part, of course, needed kind of to say what is in the non-positive case, what can you prove in for general arboreal skeleton? And I can say that it's kind of definitely there is a theorem that not every manifold, there is a constraint for a Weinstein manifold to have an arboreal skeleton in this sense, kind of like maybe there is some other notion of kind of arboreal-like skeleton which exists in more general case, but this is defined in my talk and will be defined in our paper. They have a constraint. For instance, I think if like C3 is not zero, searching class that such thing does not exist. So there are three main ingredients in our proof. So one, we call theory of positive cotangent buildings. Second, theory of rigid Lagrangian and their arborealization. So that's already redundant. Okay, the theory of rigid Lagrangian arborealization, it's kind of the same thing. Kind of, but okay, so this should be crossed out from the second part. So first, kind of before defining this cotangent, so the cotangent building, I want to just kind of describe some kind of toolkit what you can do with WC manifold. So this WC manifold is in fact extremely really flexible thing, which kind of like Lego from which you can build a lot of complex things from out of very simple thing. So first of all, given if you have a two Weinstein manifold and with boundary, we have a two Weinstein manifold with boundary, and suppose you have a boundary face, and you fix some nuclear on one boundary and nucleus on the other boundary, and if there is a Liouville isomorphism between this nuclei, then this is a straightforward allows us to glue this two manifolds that just take them together and like similar like gluing two manifolds with boundary along their boundary, or gluing two manifolds with boundaries quarter around along their faces. So this is a kind of exactly parallel operation, and kind of it's straightforward. So we refer to this operation as horizontal gluing. But also we would like to kind of to do the following operation. So suppose you started with some manifold, WC manifold, and now you have a Weinstein hypersurface sitting here. So first thing, you can just transform this Weinstein hypersurface to boundary phase, as I told you. And then you can, if you take another manifold, WC manifold, which kind of have a boundary nucleus, which is the same as this one, you can glue them together. So the conversion of hypersurface into boundary nucleus followed by horizontal gluing, we call vertical gluing. So for instance, this kind of say handle attachment is of course this type of operation, because handle is this WC manifold with boundary. And then if you have some kind of Legendrian, and you have this Legendrian have a kind of canonical ribbon, this cotangent bundle, and this neighborhood of this cotangent bundle can be kind of deformed, as I said, locally, canonically transformed into boundary phase, and then we glue them, and this is a handle attachment. So cotangent block is just the germ of cotangent bundle over C manifold. By C manifold, I mean manifold with boundary with corner. It is by itself double C manifold. So this is a cotangent block. A cotangent building of height K made of cotangent block by the above operation which I described. So you just take this ordered sequence of block and you start to do this one. So height one building and just cotangent block B1 itself. Suppose we already defined building what I call W greater than one by gluing all blocks from case to second. And then the new WC manifold may have some kind of boundary phase and it has a nucleus. And I can realize this nucleus in the first block as a kind of Weinstein hypersurface as the first block, and then do this vertical gluing. And this is what it is. So this is kind of like it's in some sense kind of very nice picture. So you can either start gluing from the top, so you start from the top block and glue top to previous to case minus one, and that result to K minus two, etc. Or you can start doing in more traditional sense gluing from the bottom. But when you're gluing from the bottom, next block, you glue along several faces to different blocks which you already built before. So this is a kind of like alternative in some sense to handle body decomposition of Einstein manifold, which we found kind of more kind of better object to deal with. So given the cotangent building, so in fact, you can prove the following theorem, that each of this, suppose you have this cotangent building, and then when we build this building, remember we were doing some kind of boundary gluing. So let's strip our manifold M and corresponding cotangent bundle of boundary faces which we glued somewhere. For instance, if we glued B2 to B1 using boundary face of B2, then we just strip this boundary that remove it, so it have an open thing. So therefore, what you get this manifold MJ circle and BJ circle, kind of semi-interior of this block. Maybe not complete interior, because I maybe kind of some boundary faces maybe still remain. And then turns out that you can embed each of this block into our manifold, so they just sit there, kind of, in such a way that union of this MJ is just give us skeleton of the our manifold, union of this kind of zero section give us skeleton. And like, if you take a block with bigger number, then this kind of strip of this boundary block does not intersect at all image of the core of the lower block. And on the intersection, on the kind of part of intersection which over nucleus, this form coincides. So I don't have time to talk about this in more details, but kind of the picture is the following, that from the point of view of our each block, induced Liouville form from other block near the boundary are completely standard. They are just obtained by its Liouville form by kind of some kind of conversion of this d of du to d of dt direction, as we will discuss earlier. So I left a blank page because I thought to draw some picture, but maybe I will not. Okay. So now we have a kind of like in order to make this kind of like cotangent building structure, we need to be able to redo how to quantize. For instance, I started with Weinstein manifold, and I want to remake it into cotangent building. So then I have this handle body decomposition. And suppose, say, I already rebuilt everything in the cotangent building except the last handle. And now I need to make this last handle into this last block. And this imposes the following constraint, that this attaching Legendrian has to be kind of very special kind. So it means that it can be viewed as Legendrian on like in one block. So you have this kind of one block and another block attached. And now you have a in the boundary of this Legendrian. And this Legendrian is a have to be in very special position. Namely, here I have a Liouville field of this block and Liouville field of this block. And my Legendrian, in order to have this kind of structure, if I hope this to be core of additional block, then what it implies that this Legendrian has to be invariant in each corner with respect to all Liouville fields which are defined there. So here is, of course, this Legendrian. If you take a kind of Lagrangian cone over this Legendrian, then it will be invariant with respect to Liouville field. But in this corner, it will be invariant with respect to, it will be like double cone. And like if you have a triple corner, it will be triple cone. And so kind of one of the technical lemma, which is important, that given any Legendrian, you can, by Legendrian isotopy, always move it to this special split position. And as a result, you have this kind of lemma that any Weinstein manifold can be presented, or WC manifold can be presented as this cotangent building. And I say that every Legendrian can be kind of moved to this kind of special Legendrian with this invariant property. So that's what it says. But the corollary of this, that any WC structure on manifold always homotopic to a structure of cotangent bindilco of some height k. And as I said, this is kind of like different version of handle body decomposition, kind of better adjusted for this our purposes. So let's see how far this cotangent bundle picture is from cotangent building picture, how far is from having skeleton arboreal. So the problem is the following. So you have this our each Lagrangian, and then question how this Lagrangian intersect, how this Lagrangian intersect with kind of core of blocks to which they attach. And for that, we need that this kind of corresponding Legendrian project as immersion, and is an immersion with transverse intersection. Of course, having transverse intersection is a generic property, so it's kind of always can be achieved by perturbation, but being immersion is far from being generic. So the whole fight is in the proof is starting from this building, now kind of make it into arboreal. That means that to achieve transversality of projection of corresponding Legendrian. So for this, we need this positivity just come there. So let me talk a little bit about some linear symplectic algebra. So there is a, on the space of Lagrangian, there is a kind of cyclic partial order, if you will. So given any two Lagrangian plane, we can consider all Lagrangian plane, which kind of transverse to both, and therefore they can be viewed as a kind of quadratic form with respect to this polarization. And we consider this kind of pole, which we call not positive cone, we call it positive zone, is some kind of like consisting of all Lagrangian plane, which correspond to positive definite quadratic form. So if you have any kind of such Lagrangian in this positive zone, then we say that like the tau, the zero section precede this L kind of with respect to this polarization nu. But then one can check that there is some kind of cyclic property. That if you have this triple, then L in this cone on tau nu, then nu in the cone of L tau, et cetera. So the whole thing is kind of like cyclic, certain cyclic order. And therefore, we can talk about cyclic order of Lagrangian in any symplectic vector space. So the following linear algebra is a kind of key for achieving the transversality which you need. So again, let's take a cotangent ball of Rn and a tau nu zero section and normal fiber. And suppose we took some Lagrangian, which is transverse both to zero and nu. And then suppose there's this triple is this ordered in this order, like first tau, then nu, and then eta. And then for any hyperplane pi in Rn, conormal Lagrangian to this hyperplane is transverse to eta. And this kind of like that, and in fact, it turns out that this positivity or negativity, it's kind of can replace it by negative definite, but this is a kind of necessary insufficient condition because this transversality to any hyperplane is in fact means that this our quadratic form is positive or not vanishing on any vector. And this is what it means. So why do we need this property? Because we constantly deal with multiple projection. In this picture, we take some Legendrian and we project one block. And result of this projection, we can project now kind of this cone of this projection project to the lower block. And so therefore, we can maybe achieve transversality of projection to the first block, but then we are not in control of this transversality of projection of this cone to the second block, and the only kind of way how we can ensure the transversality via this, as we found, via this positivity property. So I will, in order to formulate kind of my main theorem, I need one more definition. Suppose we have again in vector space, you have a Lagrangian, you have a quasiotropic. So then by this L kind of with sub C, I will be denoting this symplectic reduction corresponding to this quasiotropic submanifold. And in the case of the building, there are very special quasiotropics, namely symplectic dual to line spanned by Liouville vector field. And so in the reduction with respect to this quasiotropic, I will be just denoting LJ instead of kind of writing the whole thing. And so now one more notion. Suppose you have some point in kind of interior of one of this core of one of the block, and I will denote by kind of M of this point maximal index such that A intersect with some block lower than this J block, kind of like highest block containing this my point A. And then positivity condition means this kind of strange property, some kind of like cyclic order for the reduction of three Lagrangian plane of the polarization of J's block, polarization of I's block, and the tangent plane to J's block. But this does not make sense without reduction, because without reduction, this they are not transverse. But after reduction, they transverse, and that we can ask it. And as I said, the theorem which we prove kind of like is we proving that WSU manifold admit a structure positive cotangent bundle if and only if it is polarized. And moreover, this positive structure uniquely determines the homotopy class of the polarization. We know that the skeleton of generic positive cotangent complexes automatically, generic, I said generic because you need this kind of transversality of self-intersection, which kind of not automatic. And it's automatically positive arboreal space. And therefore, as soon as we prove the theorem, this our theorem about positive arboreal skeleton follows. And conversely, any positive arboreal space serves as a skeleton of positive cotangent complex. So this is in some sense equivalent thing to try to construct this cotangent complex positive or arboreal skeleton. So let me now just briefly mention this our second ingredient, and about the Ricci Lagrangian. So Ricci Lagrangian is a kind of like very kind of nice object. So kind of one-dimensional Ricci Lagrangian. This is a one-dimensional Ricci Lagrangian. So you take this piecewise smooth line with corners, and then like high dimensional ridges are just product of this. So you take this kind of what is denoted here R12 is just precisely kind of this corner, and then you can just take a product of k copy of this and plus kind of this Rn minus k to complete to smooth part, and this is called ridge of order k. And so like for instance, example, if you take a like order, maximal order ridge, this is a union, you take a standard quadrant in Rn and that positive quadrant, it take conormal to its faces of all dimensions. So you get 2 to the n kind of possible faces. And this is a kind of, that's exactly structure of this ridge of order n. So n-dimensional region Lagrangian is a just symplectic in symplectic manifold is a subset which kind of locally can be covered by chart isomorphic to the standard ridges. And the theorem which we prove in kind of actually in another paper which was already on archive says that if you have a cotangent bundle and in the cotangent bundle you have any Lagrangian distribution with any position to zero section, and then by C0 small Ridge Lagrangian isotopy, by Ridge Lagrangian isotopy means the following thing. You can like start with smooth Lagrangian, you can create like deform it first to Ridge, and after that move it by just Hamiltonian ambient Hamiltonian isotopy. By Ridge Lagrangian isotopy, you can move zero section into position which is transverse to the distribution. So this is kind of strange theorem. It's kind of H principle without any conditions. So kind of like you always can achieve without any assumption. So we know that neighborhood of any Ridge admits a unique up to homotopy Weinstein structure for which the Lagrangian is its skeleton, which is kind of easy to prove. And like theorem that you have a Ridge Lagrangian transverse to Lagrangian distribution, then canonical Weinstein structure can be deformed to make it arboreal. And again, transverse to eta. So this is a kind of like, in some sense, pretty kind of strange statement, because one would say, okay, so maybe why do we want to, of course we want transversality to some distribution because we want transversality of certain projection. But why would we, kind of like in general, maybe such statement holds without kind of like mentioning any Lagrangian, but that you, any Ridge can be arborealized, but turns out that it's not true. So this is kind of like, this is a point where this kind of like, we realized that in fact, there are extra conditions in order to find arboreal skeleton of any kind of positive or non-positive. Okay, and I think I finished.